Expectations were high from those both on and off the yard for the Navy women's basketball team as it entered the 2013-14 season, and understandably so. After all, the Mids did not lose a player to graduation from the previous year's team that shared the regular season title in the Patriot League and advanced to a third straight NCAA tournament. Shouldering much of the reasoning for those lofty standards was Navy's class of 2014, the Fab Five of Audrey Bauer, Jade Geif, Alex Membreno, M.L. Morrison, and Kara Pollinger had already etched their names into Navy's basketball lore with the success of the program at each of their first three seasons. Their final season would be one to add another chapter to the most successful four-year run in school history. The year began with the Mids spoiling the inaugural game to be played in Towson's new arena. 2 days later, Navy opened up its home schedule by scoring 13 of the game's first 14 points on its way to cruising past the Stony Brook team that would play second in the America East Conference. A close call to eventual MAC regular season champion Iona was followed by a runaway win over St. Peter's in New Jersey. From there, it was on to Middle America. After starting the trip by scoring the most points in a regulation game by a Navy team in two decades in a rout of Oral Roberts, the Mids flew to Minneapolis for a game against Geif's hometown Big Ten team, Minnesota. Dinner at the Geif home the night before the game was followed by the local player scoring the first points of the game against the Gophers to spark the Mids to a quick 7-0 lead. With family and friends seated in all the same stands where she herself had sat while growing up, Geif played all 40 minutes of Navy's eventual 7-point loss to the Gophers, made all but three of her field goal attempts, and scored 17 points while pulling down 10 boards. Buoyed by its play against Minnesota, a team that would win 22 games, Navy embarked on a 3-game winning streak against Brown, Rider, and Mount St. Mary's before falling to the 4-time defending Ivy League champion, Princeton Tigers. Navy's final game of the 2013 calendar was yet another homecoming event, this time for Kara Pollinger. A visit by the Mids to the Pollinger family homestead led to seemingly all of Fort Gay, West Virginia, to be in attendance the next day as Navy took on Marshall. Chloe Stapleton staked the Mids to several double-digit leads as she sank 8 3-point field goals in the game. But it was Pollinger who accounted for some key baskets down the stretch as her 15 points and 6 rebounds helped Navy to secure the victory. Despite playing the fewest number of non-league games since joining the Patriot League, Navy posted its highest number of wins in non-league games in over a decade. The win over the Herd was also the 100th for head coach Stephanie Pemper at Navy. By the end of the year, that tally had increased to 116, and her career winning percentage of over 60% leads all previous Navy mentors. The league season is always a rigorous test, but the 2014 Patriot League campaign was made even more so as the addition of Loyola and Boston University extended the league season to 18 games over 9 weeks. The Mids would face the two new league members over the first three games of the year. Navy stormed out of the gate in its opener against the Greyhounds. The Mids ripped off the first 16 points of the game, with Bauer accounting for 10 of those points. She would go on to score 20 points in the first half, which broke her own single-game career high, to help stake Navy to a 45-17 advantage and help the Mids successfully open the league campaign. After posting a 14-point road win over Lafayette, the Mids returned home to face the Terriers in just the second meeting between the teams. Navy held a 7-point lead at the break, then used a pair of 7-0 runs early in the second half to run away from Boston and improved to 3-0 in league play. Also with a 3-0 record in league play was Army, and the two service academy programs would meet in the very next game. With the national television audience watching, the Black Knights jumped out to an early lead, only to see the Mids catch them and then use a late first-half run to take an 8-point lead at the break. That helped to make the halftime ceremony honoring Becky Dowling as the first women's basketball player to have her jersey retired a happier one. As the game resumed, Navy's lead grew to double figures several times, only to see Army slice it down to as few as 5 points. But the free-throw shooting of the Mids as a whole, and of Geif in particular, helped them stave off the Black Knights and secure victory. There's no rest for the weary during a league season, and that was especially so for the Mids in their next game. Navy had to put aside not only the toll of an Army-Navy game, but also several illnesses on the team when it went on the road to face Bucknell. The Bison took advantage of Navy's offensive struggles early on to build a 9-point lead, but the Mids rallied to tie the game at the half and take a slim 5-point lead after intermission. Navy seemingly had the game won until Bucknell hit a jumper as the horn sounded to force overtime. The same sequence of a late Navy lead and a buzzer-beating Bucknell basket repeated itself at the end of the first extra period to extend the game another 5 minutes. And though the Bison had yet another opportunity to win the game, this time the Mids were able to hang on and win 94-92 in a game that was tied 16 times and saw the lead change hands 19 times. Guyf and Membrenna were two of the Mids who fought through illnesses to not only play, but lead Navy in the win. Guyf scored 13 points and grabbed 17 rebounds, while Membrenna poured in 34 points, the most by any Mid against a Patriot League foe in school history, and notched the 1,000th point of her career in the process. A 31-point rout of Colgate by the Mids was followed by a road win at Lehigh. Pollinger would be the catalyst for Navy, securing wins in their next two games. She was 6 of 6 from the foul line in the closing minutes of a 7-point win at Holy Cross, then made 4 3-point field goals to score 17 points in a defensive struggle for both teams against American. The 48-44 win over the Eagles gave Navy a 9-0 record after the first half of the league season. The 9 straight wins was the longest winning streak recorded by any Navy team, and the 10 consecutive victories overall left the Mids one short of tying the school record. Those streaks came to an end, however, in Navy's next game as a hot shooting Lafayette squad edged the Mids by 1 point in Alumni Hall. Navy would split its next two games, winning at Boston and losing at Army, but ran off wins in its next 4 contests. That run started with another taut affair against Bucknell. The score was tied with 3 minutes left when Bauer drained a 3-point shot not only to break the tie, but score the 1,000th point of her career, and also ignited a game-closing 12-2 run by the Mids. Bauer wasn't the only Mid to have a grand night against the Bison. Pollinger was 6 of 7 from long range and scoring a career-high 27 points, and also recording career point number 1,000. Navy carried that momentum into its next two games, a 29-point win at Colgate, and a 20-point win at home against Lehigh. The Mids would then close out their slate of home regular season games in its next contest against Holy Cross. Navy took time before the game to recognize its historic senior class, but it was back to business as soon as the game started. The Mids entered the second half clinging to a 2-point lead before slowly edging their way out to a double-digit advantage. The triumvirate of Bauer, Guyf, and Membrenna accounted for 53 points and 24 rebounds to help the Mids win on Senior Day for the 10th year in a row. Navy entered its final two road games with much to play for. The Mids had already assured themselves of at least a share of the Patriot League regular season title, but needed one win to become the first Navy team to win the crown outright. American's defensive effort limited the Navy offense in a midweek loss in our nation's capital, but the Mids showed no ill effects from the setback 3 days later at Loyola. Navy scored their first 8 points of the game, all of which were tallied by Guyf to set the tone for the afternoon. The Mids led by as many as 15 points in the first half and used a 15-0 run in the second half to convincingly secure a Patriot League championship. Additionally, the win gave Pemper a Navy record 60 Patriot League regular season victories and helped her earn the second Patriot League Coach of the Year honor of her career. She has guided Navy to winning league seasons in each of her 6 seasons, a feat only the Mids and American have accomplished over this time. Navy set another mark with its next win, an eventual 30-point victory over Lehigh in the quarterfinal round of the Patriot League tournament. The win that made Navy the lone league team to have won a tournament game in 6 straight seasons also set a new school record for victories in a season with the team's 24th of the year. The Mids had enjoyed unprecedented success in March over the last few seasons. Navy entered the year as one of just 2 teams to have won as many as 3 Patriot League titles in a row. Alas, Navy's run would be stopped in the semifinal round of the event by a hot-shooting Holy Cross team that advanced to the championship game of the event for the 3rd year in a row. Despite the loss to the Crusaders, the Mids still represented the Patriot League in March Madness as they were tabbed to play at Old Dominion in the first round of the WNIT. Navy quickly embraced the opportunity ahead of it as it traveled to Norfolk to face the Lady Monarchs in front of a significant number of fans of the Mids and one of the top ports for the Navy as a whole. And those fans viewed the grit and fight that symbolized this year's Mids. A late run gave the home team a 9-point lead at halftime, but Navy answered by regaining the lead 8 minutes into the second half. Old Dominion responded with a charge of its own to take a 7-point lead, but that advantage was down to just a one-possession difference with 100 seconds remaining. The Lady Monarchs sealed the win over a span of 15 seconds as a fortuitous basket as the shot clock expired for ODU was followed by a 3-point miss that was halfway through the cylinder before defying gravity and spinning out for the Mids. The disappointment felt by losses in the last two games doesn't diminish the accomplishments of this year's Navy team. Playing with the pressures of being the team that everyone was aiming to take down, the Mids still set themselves apart from the rest of the competition in both victory and defeat. Expectations will remain high for the Mids come the fall, and many pieces to that new puzzle earn valuable minutes this season. Stapleton started all but one game this year and proved herself to be one of the most feared three-point shooters in the league. Plead point guard Sarita Condi displayed flashes reminiscent of Pollinger as a freshman, and soon-to-be juniors Perry Curtis and Chelsea Terry took advantage of increased roles this year to far surpass their respective production last season. Additionally, Rebecca Richmond and Aaron Metter will be looked upon to contribute after each recover from knee injuries, while having a season under their belts on the college level will help to provide more opportunities next year for freshmen Sarah Jones, Ashanti Kennedy, and Danielle Poblar. But the story of this season ends the way it started, with the class of 2014. Bauer, who will be commissioned as a surface warfare officer in May, appeared in every possible game in her career and made at least 1 3-point field goal in all but 20 of those 129 games. She ranks third at Navy and eighth in Patriot League history with 215 career 3-point field goals made, ranks eighth for career 3-point field goal percentage, and snared over 600 rebounds in her career. Bauer excelled in the classroom as well, as twice she was named to the Patriot League All-Academic Team. Like Bauer, future Marine Geif didn't miss a game in her career. The two-time Patriot League Tournament MVP and three-time All-League honoree is the lone player in Patriot League history to have been named to four All-Tournament teams. She amassed over 1,500 points, 1,000 rebounds to join David Robinson and Vernon Butler as the lone Navy basketball players with over 1,000 of each. One of just two Mids to lead Navy in rebounds in each of her four seasons, she holds the school record for career rebounds and stands second for both career field goal percentage and minutes played. Membreno was a do-it-all player for the Mids throughout her 4 years. Points, rebounds, assists, steals, and blocks. More often than not, her name could be found near the top of several of them after every game. The MVP of the 2013 Patriot League tournament earned all-league accolades three times in her career. She tallied over 1,200 points, made nearly 100 three-point field goals, and swiped more than 150 steals. The Navy pilot-to-be ranks eighth at Navy with both 341 assists and 761 rebounds. Morrison showed improvement throughout her career. The future Navy pilot increased her season totals for games and minutes played, field goals made, three-point field goals made, points and blocks from 1 year to the next in each of her four seasons, while totaling nearly 200 rebounds over her final two campaigns. Pollinger started every game over her last 3 years and during that time scored over 1,000 points. The two-time team captain and future Navy pilot twice was named to the Patriot League's All-Tournament Team and this season garnered first-team All-Patriot League honors. She drilled over 200 three-point field goals in her career, including a Navy single-season record 87 this season, stands fifth at Navy with 364 career assists, and ranked among the nation's leaders in assist-to-turnover ratio. Collectively, they raised the program to new heights, while their mark as individuals is in the record books. Their overall body of work includes a school record for career wins by a single class, being part of three of the five 20-win seasons in school history, sharing two and winning one outright league regular season titles after Navy had shared the title just once prior to their arrival. Made the first three trips to the NCAA tournament by any Navy team and made four appearances in postseason national tournaments. Five individuals from five different states, each with different backgrounds, skill sets, and personalities, both on and off the court. Each brought something unique to the program, but together They complemented each other into one cohesive unit and into the greatest class in Navy women's basketball history. They truly are in a class of their own.
Live or die. Just gotta believe.